Okay, question one. Prove it, so 6 to the power of n minus 1 is divisible by 5. So prove it's true for n equals 1. So everywhere you see an n, stick in a 1, and you get 5, and that is divisible by 5. 5 divided by 5 is 1, so it's divisible by 5, so this is true. So that's it proved. Right, then assume it's true for n equals k. So that means 6 to the k minus 1 is divisible by 5. Okay, and then I need to prove it's true for n equals k plus 1. So prove true then for n equals k plus 1. So I'm trying to prove that 6 to the power of k plus 1 minus 1 is divisible by 5. So you change that to a 6 multiplied by 6 to the power of k minus 1. You break up the 6 then into a 5 plus 1. So this dictates what you break it up into. So it's 5 plus 1 multiplied by 6 to the power of k minus 1. Multiply out. Okay, so multiplying out there, we'll get 5 multiplied by 6 to the power of k plus 1 multiplied by 6 to the power of k, which is just 6 to the power of k. Sorry, that should be a plus. And then I have a minus 1. So this is divisible by 5, because anything multiplied by 5 is divisible by 5. And this is divisible by 5, because that was your assumption. That's divisible by 5. So if the two bits are divisible by 5, the whole lot, 6 to the power of k plus 1 minus 1 is divisible by 5. And then you write your four sentences. It's true for n equals 1. It's true for n equals k. It's true for n equals k plus 1. Therefore, it's true for all n element of n. Right, they're the five sentences you put at the end of every sum, okay? Right, so number 2, I'm going to use the same board. Right, okay, so I want to prove 5 to the power of n minus 1 again is divisible by 4. Okay, so you assume it's true for n equals 1. So that means 5 to the power of 1, take away 1, that will give me 4. And 4 is clearly divisible by 4, so that is true statement. You assume it's true for n equals k, so that means 5 to the power of k, take away 1, is divisible by 4. Okay, and you prove it's true for n equals k plus 1. So that means we're trying to prove that 5 to the power of k plus 1 minus 1 is divisible by 4. So you change this into 5 multiplied by 5 to the power of k. That's 5 to the power of 1 by 5 to the power of k. It's 5 to the power of k plus 1. Then you break up the 5 into a 4 plus 1. So that's 4 plus 1 multiplied by 5 to the power of k minus 1. So then you multiply into the brackets. So I'm going to come over here. So you go 4 multiplied by 5 to the power of k plus 1 multiplied by 5 to the power of k is just 5 to the power of k minus 1. So this bit is divisible by 4, because if you multiply it by 4, you can divide it by 4. And here, this is divisible by 4, because that was your assumption. So if the two bits are divisible by 4, the whole lot is divisible by 4. So you go, therefore, 5 to the power of k plus 1 is divisible by 4. So then you write your four sentences. True for n equals 1, true for n equals k, true for n equals k plus 1, therefore true for all n element of n.